Okay, guys, with forward-facing sonar, you can catch any bait with forward-facing sonar by using it, but there are some baits that are, I think, better than others when you're trying to learn it. And that's what this video is. If you're trying to get better at forward-facing sonar, one thing I do when I go out in the boat with people and teach them that and go through these trips, I have certain baits that I like to use to teach them. We're about to talk about that. We're about to talk about my five favorite baits to learn how to use the forward-facing sonar to get better with it. Now, guys, you can, like I said, you can use any bait, a jig, worm, jerk bait, any bait, but these are the baits I use. Now, we also got to think about it, guys, is the season. The season, okay? Because, like, when it's middle of summer, I don't throw an Alabama rig, but an Alabama rig is one of my lures that we're going to get into. So we kind of got to look at the season. So some of these are for year-round. Some of these are for the season, but welcome to the Fishing Coach. I'm Coach E, go by Jimmy Easterling. Appreciate you guys. Hit the subscribe button for me down there. Help me grow the channel, trying to grow this thing, and appreciate everybody that's been involved. And at the end, we'll have our Faith Juice segment as well. So as I said, guys, the first one I love to teach people with and to learn how to use with forward-facing is the Alabama rig. Now, guys, I'm going to put all my baits and information down there in the description if you're curious which ones I'm using. This right here is just a flash mob, and right now we're in the fall, winter's approaching. The Alabama rig is great, and one thing I like about it, guys, is it attracts fish, it draws fish, and so you get to see fish come up there and either eat it or how when they don't eat it, okay? And that's one thing is good, guys, is learning how when fish do not react to lures, how do you need to change and adapt. And so, like, right now I've not caught a fish on this yet. I throw this out there, reel it, they come up and look at it, go back, I put it down quick because I know when they eat this thing, they eat this thing, okay?
Yeah, watch that one, dude. That's a good one, too.
I watched that one. Look at them all coming out. Look at that big one there. Look at that big one there, dude. One thing about the Alabama rig, too, is it shows up really well on forward-facing sonar. It's bigger, five swim baits, your wires, your blades. It really shows up big. So it's something you can see far away and helps me determine on your unit when I go out in your boat how distance we can see, and then how when I play with the settings and all that good stuff, okay? The second lure that I like, okay, and there's so many in here, okay? The second lure that I like to teach with, and you guys know and watch a lot, is the flutter spoon. And lately, this year, I've had a couple good trips with it, more in the post-spawn, but I've not done as well with it. Now, in the winter, I had a couple trips with it as well. But the thing about this flutter spoon is, it also, as earlier I mentioned with Alabama rig, it draws fish. It catches big fish, but it draws them. It's a big piece of metal. You can see it well. You get to see how fish react, swim around it, you know, and how they eat it and don't eat it, okay? So a flutter spoon is something that as well. Now this is the Dixie Jet Talon. It's on the Level NGX 710 medium heavy fast. I also throw in the 7.8 heavy fast as well.
What is this? Got him. That's a big one.
Get in here.
Look at that, guys.
Get in here. Look at that big old black. Look at that big old black. Look at that black. Got the black stripes and all. Dixie in the house. That's so cool, guys. I got that one filmed. I got that one filmed. This video today is brought to you by Triple B Asphalt Company, guys. And let me share with you some benefits of seal coating, one of their biggest things that this asphalt company does, and I've learned a lot about it. Let's say you work at a bank, or you have a church, a cemetery, big parking lot where you're at, or if it's your own driveway, guys, there's a lot of benefits of seal coating, as I've learned about. One thing is it extends the life of your asphalt, okay? From the wear and tear of the rain, the snow, okay? Also, with all the elements that come from time and time again, it starts to become faded, and then cracks show up, and then potholes comes up. That's where Triple B comes into play. Guys, they're located in Northwest Arkansas, but he has done work in Central Arkansas, and also being in Northwest, he is not afraid to go up into the Missouri area, up in that area, guys. If you're more interested in hearing more about Triple B Asphalt Company, as I appreciate them being a part of the Fishing Coach YouTube channel and my business, guys, there'll be more information on them in the description. Appreciate it. Let's go get into the video. Love the flutter spoon. I actually caught some fish with you the other day and didn't get that on footage for you guys. I'm sorry. Martin Johnson. It was at Lake Hamilton, and I've been trying. Okay, so now, guys, the third one, okay? Now, the third one, which is one that, of course, everybody wants to learn. I'm not going to go into depth on it really, really much, but it is the jig head minnow. Okay, it is. I call it the jig head minnow. There's a bunch of different ways about it. Or you can call it the Damiki rig. This hover strolling. We got the hover rig. Okay, the hover rig goes in this category too, guys. You know, I'm with Core Tackle, so the hover rig goes in this too. And I kind of learned when to throw the hover rig and the jig head minnow. So the hover rig's kind of in this. So this right here is
riding. There's areas they can live. Then there's areas where, come on.
Oh, that's a good one.
Come on.
That's a good one.
Oh, 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 oh. Boom!
How about that? You got one of those dudes to bite?
Just a quarter ounce head for the baby Z2. I throw a variety of different minnows, but like right now, fall, kind of the winter's gonna go back to that smaller size. Throwing this on 7-1 medium light. That's one thing about this, guys. Is the action of the rod. This rod here, I love it. I love it. I wish I had it last winter. I'm excited about this winter throwing this thing because I've been wearing them out with it throughout the summer, and now they're eating it back in the fall. And I've been with people on my trips, and they don't catch fish with it. And I really think at times, and they're new, like I said, they're new to it, and it takes some stuff. I think the rod action is key. And I even let them throw this at times. I go through other stuff I've talked about on the channel. I've even talked about like the loop knot rod here, you know. Take you big old thick fish with the hover rig. I like my reel on the right side because it helps me with the shake, because I'm more comfortable with the reel on my left hand. There's so many things about this, but one cool thing with this is it's very powerful at forward face, and everybody wants to learn and talk about it. So, and it does catch his fish, but guys, there's time where it doesn't catch fish. Okay, it's not the cure all. There's a lot of these younger guys I get in the boats with on these lessons, and they learn this, and then that's all they want to do is throw it. And yes, it does catch fish pretty well, and it can, on tough days, I've seen it on tough days, overcome. But there's a time where like these other things will beat this. Okay, we'll beat it. Now, the fifth one, I should have said this earlier. We're gonna go in the fourth one. I'm kind of torn on the fourth one, but the fifth one's one you would not think about, okay, when I do the lessons. But the fourth one is a hair jig. Oh, I got thumped.
That's a good one.
Get him in the boat. There we go. It's a big old fat fish. Yes, guys, here we go. Number one. So, guys, I've seen him out here swimming around. That fish there, I did not watch on the live scope. I just knew there's been some groups swimming around.
Okay, now I will tell you, I love the hair jig for just showing people how they react. Now we're getting in that time of year where the hair jig is not as popular. It's not as good of a lure through that post spawn through the summer. But if the winter, we'll be throwing a hair jig. I fish it different in the winter. And I would say this is where a jerkbait would come into, to where like, you know, post spawn through summer's a hair jig, and then the jerk bait's gonna be the winner. I'm not a big jerk bait guy myself, but this hair jig is pretty cool. Now, one thing I'll say with it though, guys, is, and this is the shuttlecock hair jig, one thing I will say about it is how I don't really use forward facing and watch them eat it. Like, I'll have people up there watch it, and I'm doing my thing, stepping away. Kind of messes me up watching, but it's cool to see how they react to this thing, how they go crazy. And it's just pretty neat, because when you typically hit that bite when it's on the fall.
Can't see them. That's them. Oh, need a net.
That's good.
Yes! The old hair jig, he got hooked weird.
And it's pretty cool to see them hit that thing on the fall on the live scope. But I like to kind of, when I'm getting around fish, I like to step back, fish that thing pretty, you know, straight up, okay? I don't like to always watch it. Now, guys, the last one, and this goes back to season, and it's been the season. It was May was the season, and the last 2 months and next hopefully month is, and it's topwater lures, okay? It's your walking spook style baits. It is your... These riser baits right here, like these little riser type baits, you know. There's a couple other ones, you know, a fluke. More of that.
Missed one. Got him. Oh, got a little one that time. area. Let's get
5 foot and above that 0 to 5 foot column. It is great, man. Right now there's a lot of fish high in the columns or high on spots, and it's so cool to see them come up there and eat it, and then watch and learn. Watch them even come up there and just stop and not eat it. It's like, hey, how did that fish do it? So that's one thing that I really think this time of year, it's been good for teaching, is to see them react to them, to see them when they don't. And like I said, the spooks style baits, your whopper ploppers, topwater baits is really, really overlooked, okay? And you can fish them shallow, not just open water schoolers. I'm talking up here behind me. You can see fish up there, throw that dude up, and this one go up and blow up on it. Pretty, pretty sweet. Somebody's probably watching this right now, like, Jimmy, just don't even look at the screen, and okay, I get it. But guys, I'm throwing this on level NGX71 medium live as well. It's my little versatile rod that I'm throwing all these baits on. But guys, I want you to tell me, what are your favorite baits to throw with forward facing sonar, okay? There are my five. You share with me your five, okay? If you like this type of video, let me know. And anyway, I appreciate you guys. I'm gonna go now film. I got my truck's up there. I need to film some faith juice segments, but my notes are up there. I might do those at the house. But guys, appreciate you today. Here we are at the faith juice segment, okay? I'm gonna share a little word of encouragement today, a little scripture here. And guys, let me know what you think about this segment. Appreciate the feedback and everything we have gotten. Let me know what you think about this video. I know I asked, what's your favorite scope baits? What are your favorite live scope baits? And if you don't have live scope, you could have watched this video and just learned a lot about it. So hopefully you did just kind of see how the fish react, and some of the footage is pretty, it's pretty cool. So guys, here we go. One thing I'm talking about, I know something I might have struggled with as I was younger in my life, and as I've gotten older, I've done better with it, but still, it can be there, okay? And that's about worrying and being anxious, okay? So let's say there's a situation where you're worrying about something, and it could be anything, you know, like it could be a health concern, it could be a job situation, it could be, are we going to pay a bill? There's a lot of stuff to worry about in today's world, and I'm going to kind of share right here in Matthew. We are Matthew 6:25. Therefore, I tell you, do not be anxious about your life, what you will eat or what you will drink, nor about your body, what you will put on. Is not life more than food, and the body more than clothing? And you keep kind of going through this. It talks about the birds up there. They neither sow nor reap nor gather in the barns, and then they get fed still. There's so much through here, guys. It even says down here, do not be anxious, ever saying we're going to eat, what we're going to drink. Now, this is a situation where Jesus was also talking, okay, to people here, and he kind of already knew what they were worrying about. And I know, like, depending who you are, where you're at, you don't be thinking about, I'm worried what I'm going to eat. It's more of other stuff of this world. And that was always my concern when I was younger. It was kind of like, where am I going to get my job? Where am I going to be doing this? How am I going to pay for this? And then all of a sudden, you know, now it's more like, I think if I ever worry, it's like, what am I going to be doing, you know, like in like 6 months or a year? You know, it's kind of crazy how, like, for my situation, as I gotten older, I was really like less stress of a guy. And then and that was because of me maturing, me being more in the Word and just going every day and enjoying the day. And I'd still work hard and still do all these things, guys, but I just enjoy everything. And then all of a sudden, now I'm really, like, charismatic of, like, I really don't know what's going to go on. Like, I really, like, I was talking to someone the other day when Johnny got me in this life of editing, got me out of education, got me out of a career that I had insurance, I had a retirement plan, everything's laid out, okay? So you ain't got to worry about all that. Like the education plan, guys, has a sweet retirement plan. And all this stuff, I got out of it and was his editor. Then, you know, as I was editing and doing all this stuff on the computer, I was like, I want to be on the water more. And then next thing you know, and I somehow got what I wished. Guys, you know, that was, he got me out. And I'm about to get into the, you're like, dang, I'm rambling now, but I'm not. I'm going to get to my point, okay? When I was in it, I was like, hey, I want to get on the water more. And then, you know, after about a year with the editing and working for Deep Dive, doing some different things and still making content, then all of a sudden my guide business went crazy, and I kind of got what I guess I wished. And now if you look at this year, I've been on the water almost 45% of the days, which is crazy. That's almost one of 2 days I'm on the water. I'm not saying 8-hour days. That means it's, I'm on the water at some point. It could be 4 hours. It could be three. It could be 10, okay? But now with that, there's at times I'm just like, well, what's going to be next, you know?
And that's where I start getting anxious about, you know, my kids. I got to start thinking of my kids, and I kind of think about the future a little bit. And I'm like, at the moment I'm at, I have no retirement plan. I have no, like, you know, I'm just going every day and enjoying it. And that kind of goes where I think I am almost too, I don't think so. I feel comfortable in how everything is going to work itself out. And that's because of my faith and because of just where I'm at in my maturity of life. And I just think that's how I wish probably a lot of more people would be. And someone's going to watch this and say I'm not right. But I'm in a situation now where I'm very thankful. Like today, for example, I got to go with my wife. We had both of our kids had checkups and baby checkups. And so I got to be there, got to go see her grandma. And days like this makes me appreciate, and I try not to stress and be anxious of what's tomorrow or the next day or the next day. So guys, if that's something you're struggling with, I mean, okay, shoot me a message. I can try to help talk to you. Or, like I said, just share that scripture, okay? There's somebody there that can help you if you're anxious on what tomorrow is going to be like or this, okay? Appreciate you guys. Let me know what you think about it. Hey, we'll see you on the next one.